Hi there, Alan Matthews here. Today I'd like to talk for a second about focal dystonia. It's not an Eastern European country, contrary to popular belief. It is actually a malady of the hands. Focal dystonia could actually be in any part of the body, but musicians most commonly get focal dystonia in the hands. So what it is this, and I am not a medical doctor. I don't even play one on YouTube, but there's not very much information on focal dystonia, even if you are a doctor. Doctors don't really know so much about it either. They can identify it, they can say this is what it is, but nobody really knows what to do about it. There certainly isn't a consensus on what to do about it. So this is what it is. Basically, after a time of doing something, for us, it would be playing hands, classical guitarists, it'd probably be in your right hand more than likely. After you've been doing something a lot, then the brain somehow takes those separate motions. Like if you think about arpeggio patterns, to where it's like you just like an IMA or something like that, it takes that and it just fires all of that signal all at once. So if you can imagine getting up and going and getting a glass of water and coming back and sitting back down, but your brain tells you to do everything all at the same time, then you basically go nowhere. You just freeze up. Nothing really happens. It's just a lockdown because it's just overdrive. Everything's being fired at once instead of sequentially, which is the way that it has to happen, right? We have to first get up, then we go get a glass of water, then we come back, then we sit down. If you try to do them all at the same time, you just go nowhere. Same thing in the hands. If we fire all of these actions all at the same time, then it just freezes up, and it can be pretty horrific for people to, if you've got some skill that you've been working years on. I've talked to many people about this. If you've got a skill that you have like spent your life developing and all of a sudden you can't do it anymore, it's pretty bad. It's pretty discouraging, and it's really distressing. Now, the reason that I have something to say about this is that my musical coach, Mark Westcott, is a concert pianist. Worldwide, played with most of the major orchestras in the world, TV, radio, really good player. And he got focal dystonia. Luckily, he was able to actually stave off the symptoms for about 15 years after he first realized it through some work that he did, which I'll tell you about in just a minute. And it really was able to prolong his concert career for another 15 years. Now, after that, he had some other health issues that took him off the stage, and then it progressed because he didn't continue with those particular exercises. But he was able to actually do something about it. Now, what you've basically got to do to move past or to prevent, if you suspect it coming on, is slow, exaggerated motions. So luckily, and I didn't know this before I created my arpeggio course, I'll link to it down below, but luckily the steps that I've outlined to playing arpeggios in my course actually do jive with this 100%. So I just got lucky in that way, but I'm glad, because otherwise I'd feel compelled to redo them. But basically, you break down your motions, be it scale motions, INM alternation, or your arpeggio patterns, you break them down into their smallest incremental motions, and you practice them very slow and exaggeratedly. There's just, boom, the first action. Then that finger plays, then that finger plays, and that preps. Now, in my arpeggio series, I suggest that you do everything as a snap, to where it's like, and then you wait, and then you do the next action very quick, and then you wait. For focal dystonia, if you're having symptoms of that, it may be better to actually do the movement slowly and then pause and release everything in between and then do the next one, than to actually have the snap in it. Other than that, though, it's basically the same. The basic idea is that you have to go slow, be very patient, because this could take years, and retrain your hand and mind to work together in such a way that you can actually play. People do come out of it. It's one of these things that it's not great, and there are surgeries for it, and there are all these kind of different things, but those are the iffiest things in the world. Basically, you're going in and chopping up part of your brain and hoping that it melds back together properly to actually give you that. It's pretty iffy. If you have focal dystonia, operation is not the way to go. If somebody tells you that, you should really get a second or third or fourth opinion. There are some doctors around the world who are having some success treating people. You can look into that. I'm not the one to tell you where and all that, but you can, if you're really into this, then you can Wikipedia this, and you can also, they're posting boards and forums and all kind of stuff dedicated to this. And you can also look, pianists have this a lot as well. All instrumentalists do. Musicians, the most, with the hands anyway. People also get it in their voices. The guy who wrote Dilbert comics got focal dystonia in his vocal cords. And it's in his book, which I can't remember the name of, but it was a pretty good book. But he talks about his journey, and he ended up having the surgery of like disconnecting and regrowing, and it worked for him. And so now he can speak fine. But before he couldn't for years, the guy who wrote Dilbert. So it's pretty devastating. But there are people who around the world are working on it. It is in the mix. People are working on it. But there's nothing that really truly works at this point. But people are having success anecdotally with this retraining by going very slow, very exaggerated motions, further than you would normally go with strokes in your fingers, going really slow. It basically, what you have to do is turn this into an exercise in patience and relaxation and presence. And it has to be something besides playing the guitar. If your goal is to play your Bach lute suites at tempo again, well, then you should really backburner that goal and make a much easier goal, like I'm just going to sit down and do this as an exercise unto itself, instead of this just being something that gets me there later. You should really enjoy it as it is, for what it is in the current moment, or else you may just go mad and not have the patience for it. So you have to retrain your hands, but you also have to retrain your expectations. You have to retrain your desires on what it is that you want, and just really enjoy spending time with the instrument and time physically doing something very intentional, which is a mindfulness exercise ultimately. And so it's good for health and living. So if you can do that, then maybe there is a way out of this focal dystonia thing. If not, then woe be to you. But it is a very unfortunate thing that happens, and it's a very very tragic thing that happens in many times. So I hope that helps. If you do think that this might be coming on, slow down, retrain your hands, that kind of good stuff. Be well.